Hi y'all, this is So Blessed. Welcome to the Blessed Place. How y'all doing? Anybody know what the acronym means? BOLO? BOLO is a law enforcement acronym that means be on lookout. Whenever they're looking for a suspect, such as a murder suspect, a robbery suspect, something of that nature, they will put out information pertaining to the perpetrator, and that information is considered a BOLO. I thought about this acronym as I was listening to Joel Osteen last week, and he was talking about Christians being healers and speaking healing into people's lives. I was watching this sermon and listening to this sermon as tears were just rolling down my eyes, because I had so much compassion for the fact that there are so many hurting people in this world, and especially over the last year or so, people are experiencing such tumultuous pain and suffering and depression in their lives because they are experiencing things that they've never experienced before. Having their homes foreclosed on, or if they're not foreclosed on, you're just barely holding on to your home. Having vehicles repossessed, and if they're not being repossessed, you're just barely holding on to your vehicles. Illnesses, all drug addiction, alcohol addiction, sex addictions, all kinds of things that are going on in people's lives that are causing such great pain and suffering. And as I listened to Joel Osteen and tears are just streaming down my face, like I said, I thought about this acronym because Joel Osteen was just encouraging those of us who are Christians to be on the lookout. Now, he didn't quite use those terms, but I'm using that acronym, that we should be on the lookout for those who are hurting and be able to offer healing words, to be able to offer encouragement, to be able to offer a helping hand, to be able to offer financial assistance of you if you are in the, if you are able, you know, if you're blessed to be able to offer financial assistance, being able to help, and sometimes just simply listening to people or simply asking people how they're doing and then actually waiting and listening for the answer, and not just asking how are you doing as a perfunctory remark and not actually interested in hearing the answer. Y'all, there are some, I know somebody's watching right now, not just one person, but many of you are watching right now, and you are in such pain. The emotional pain that you're going through almost feels like a physical pain, because it's transcended from just emotional to now even physical. But I want you to know that Jesus loves you. He cares for you. He says, cast all of your cares upon him because he cares for you. His yoke is easy and his burden is light, and you do not have to carry this all by yourself. Our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ has done and is still doing his part. But Christians, we must step up and do our part. What can we do? There are so many things that we can do, but here are just a few suggestions. First of all, be genuinely interested in people. Ask them how they're doing and listen to the response. Visit the sick and those who are shut in and can't get out. Give someone a call and just let them know that you're thinking about them. Send emails, send text messages, and just let people know that you're thinking about them. and that everything is going to be all right. Sometimes people just need to hear that everything's going to be all right. If you come across somebody who seems to be in despair or depressed, see how you can help them. See if there's, ask them if there's something you can pray with them about. But don't just leave it at just prayer. If you see that someone needs food, if you see a family struggling and they don't have enough to eat, if you have enough for yourself, try sharing with someone else. Go to a food bank. I'm even going to go to a food bank so that I can purchase some things for some people that I know that are in need. So you don't even have to go to your high-end stores or your regular grocery stores. Find a food bank and see what the criteria is to be able to purchase from the food bank. Like I said, there's so many things that can be done. And I know many of us are already doing those things. But this is just a reminder that people are in so much pain. And sometimes they can't hear from God right now. But they can hear from God through you, through a simple act of kindness. So be on the lookout. Bolo for the hurting. Bolo for the depressed. Bolo for the sick. Bolo for the one who's given up. Bolo for the one who has heartache and pain and insurmountable odds that they think they cannot overcome. Bolo for those people, and God will bolo for you. Be blessed.